Hey, what is going on, people? Welcome back to the Xuan Yuan Sword 7 walkthrough. And before we start, I would like to wish you guys Merry Christmas, and I hope you enjoy the Christmas episode. In this episode, we will be going through the ruins here that we came last in the last episode. And here, something interesting is you can get access to one chest just by simply bringing the bridge over this way. And quickly hop onto the bridge. Chest should be waiting right here. I remember it's an orb of harmony, the one that he used to upgrade your harnesses. There we go, orb of harmony and 1,000 chuan. So the chuan is the money. So it comes in the form of money bags. So you can unlock these money bags to get an instant cash out of money. So far, I have not found any instances that I would need these money bags to be consumed at all, but I'm pretty sure that when you combine them, you can get some specific items, and that we will find out later. So after doing the lever, you just scroll this one a little bit towards this way. Go stand on it, then that's pretty much it for this region. I still like the bear stance. I think it gives you so much.
墨者应该是什么样的人？
Crowd control and attack.
Crowd control. 什么呀，机关术这么厉害，用来帮助百姓的话不是很好吗？另一派人的想法和你一样，他们还举墨子祖师当例子。墨经记载，墨子祖师他为了天下百姓，整天四处奔走，有着“魔底放咒，以利天下”的美名。那又怎么会有机关术的禁令呢？那位巨子 担心机关术被恶人所用，就这个理由？没错，这样不是太因噎废食了吗？所以那一派的人就离开了商末，他们立志为天下人谋福，咆哮了朝廷，将所学贡献给天下。朝廷也很看重他们，专门编组了一支部队，叫做李军。 那是我懂事之前的事情了，也都是后来才听说的。但我确实见到商末和李军之间冲突越演越烈。后来，太傅将我送往西域，6年后返回中原，回到商山大寨，却只看到满目疮痍。而造成这一切的凶手，就是李俊。对，他们说的道理好像都对。
So for this one, you would want to make this shape on the left. However, you need to make them simultaneously. So by doing that, you will need rotate this. I believe that is just 2, 3. You would need 3 rows rotated this way. And as soon as you pull the lever here, there will be a centered mechanism to lock up the to synchronize both stone plates. So by rotating one, the other one will rotate as well. So you will essentially need them to be aligned to the proper synchronization. So when you move them, they kind of come to the same spot. I'm making an identical picture right here. It's mirror flipped. Alright, and that should do it.
进一季之前，我遇到了过去的一位师兄。啊，他是太傅最看重的弟子，却也投效了李君。进一季之前，我一直以为可以劝他们回心转意，现在才知道，他们已经不是以前的师兄师姐了。可，你和李君早已恩断义绝，只需信我。 等香儿的事情结束，我就会去找李君算账。Fates
are intertwined. Collect flower vases, or you call sacrificial vases. And there is a little save point. We're about to witness some main story cutscene here. Let's do it.
原来是机关工坊，怪不得要藏得如此隐秘。机关工坊，就是制作机关的地方。这儿或许会有完好的零件。太好了，这还能用。我们走吧，去放出那位前辈。嗯，无论过往的恩怨如何，但是红儿，我信你。我也相信红姐姐。
天下 K，
好美，这就是天书世界吗？天书世界能够映照一个人的内心。
内心良善的人看到的是明媚风光、花团锦簇，内心丑恶的人则会看到寸草不生的不毛之地。真的吗？我看到桃花片片，这是阳春时节哦。小鬼，你早睡来了。大王恕罪，我费尽千难万险，终于找到一位墨者了。真慢，长得本大王又长了好几根白胡子。
闲话少说，快让那个墨家小辈放我出来！是，大王稍等。那，这个送你，就当做迟来的生辰贺礼吧。
出来吗？干嘛？我不是在这儿了吗？傻愣在那儿干嘛？本大王名唤吉鹏，好好记住了。小鬼，小丫头，你便是那墨家小辈吧？机关术学的不错，就是动作慢了点。往后，本大王再好好指点指点你。 老前辈说的话，你可要认真听进去啊！
好，日后还请大王多多指点晚辈了。
你真是大王，竟是如此漂亮的鹦鹉。
废话，我吉鹏大王不是鹦鹉，难道是人啊？
吉鹏大王该不会是太过淘气，被主人关起来了吧？
胡说，我是奉大小姐之命驻守此地。
驻守？那你为何会困在机关里，一困就是十几年？
大小姐用心良苦，小鬼你们猜不透的。这样说话实在挺累，小丫头，你的手给本大王站一会儿。
我已依约放出大王，就请大王指导修复躯体的方式了。
修复人体的方式繁复，但其实与炼化妖魔相差无几。先按本大王的指示炼化一头妖魔试试看吧。这炼化妖魔素材的挑选可是很重要的，会决定产出的结果。等等，听本大王指示再下手。凡是越稀有的妖魔，炼化时所需要的素材就更要谨慎，把握个八成，修复人体也是一样的道理。好，就把这素材加下去。
真的可以，
天书可真是几乎无所不能了。
本大王说话从不夸张，能做到的事就是能做到。
太好了，香儿，马上为你修复身躯。没问题的。
嗯，香囊先系上去，这样可以静心辟邪，
消灾解厄，百毒不侵。
动手吧。
成功了吗？
啊，这气息不对劲，是黑火，黑火妖魔，快转移，快出天书。
殿下，
And things went south.
冷静。
Okay, this boss fight can be quite. Can be quite hard to fight because all this poison, it will just murder you so fast.Fade out all the poison. Oh no no no, not good, not good. Go into the poison and remember to, stay still when she does that. Yep, and walk through the poison here.And don't get her melee on you. If it's gonna hurt. If not too shiny. Martial arts whenever possible, that would help you a lot. Two hits, nothing more. Okay, unlock. Walk through the gaps. May seem not like anime like, you know, trading blows and whatnot, but that's the safest way because she got a lot of potential to just one shot you. Okay, do that. When she charges toward you, like, you can dodge.
阿兄再想想办法啊。
没事，不要紧，没关系，别担心，你只会说这些敷衍我。
阿兄，我也是。
阿兄，你又不是我亲阿兄。
你，
反正我什么忙也帮不上，还只会拖累你，何必一口一个的阿兄，干脆不要管我好了。
红姐姐也会帮忙的，我们一起想想办法，好吗？
你说十拿九稳，为什么就失败了？身躯半点不存。
本大王才想问你呢，为何小丫头的躯体里会有黑火的气息？
你说什么？
我说黑火，黑火。
莫不是那时，仙儿被黑雾大妖所伤？留下的气息，
幸亏本大王发现得早，否则遭殃的不止小丫头的身体，天书世界的邪律也会大受影响。
你倒是怪起我来了。
这是自然，炼化时掺入黑火根本就是疯了，全天下能够驾驭黑火的也只有我们大小姐了。
那眼下该如何修复香儿的身躯？
烧得半点不存了，如何修复？
你说了要助香儿修复身躯，这是我们的交易。
没有东西可以交易了，只好取消交易。
妥，既然交易取消了，那我就把你关回去吧。
慢着，还有一个法子。
说。
要想从无到有，炼化出人类身躯，只能利用黑火。
刚刚就那么一丝黑火气息便失控至此。
我说了，全天下能够驾驭黑火的只有我们大小姐。本大王正要去找她，就好心收你们一程吧。走啦走啦。 去找大小姐。
有法子了，不过就是麻烦了点。大王的尊长金善炼化之道，可以驾驭黑火，炼出人类躯体。
当真？
本大王说的自然不假。
香儿，我们走。
嗯，
走吧走吧，出去说。
我回到巴蜀，那儿景色依旧。到了无名丘，便想起过去的事。故人不在，留我一人独自面对。黑火妖魔必须消灭，我便全力反击。轩辕剑不该落入他人手中，我便封印了他。只是夫君，我真的累了。
And it is believed most of these people back then, or according to the legends, they could live hundreds of years, if not thousands of years.
据大王所言，目前几个可能的地点：巴蜀、无名丘、鬼谷雪地。而且这位大小姐，很有可能就是传闻中的那位
御医女子。
没礼貌！大小姐岂是你们这群小辈叫的？要叫夫人。
是。
以绿衣女子的传闻推断，目前最有可能的方位是北边，鬼谷雪地。
北边要开始打仗了，怕是交通不易。途经御水的时候，先去和文叔打个招呼。
Yeah, if not hundreds of years, if not thousands of years, and we have just gotten us another.Stance, the tiger stance. So we'll just keep the bear stance around. So I think that will do us more help than the wolf stance. Wolf stance is more like single target. Tiger stance, it has a little kick like this, and you cannot do a sprint attack yet.Here, there should be a fight. Focus. The one that is holding
the
kind of the healer of the party. Tiger stance, something good about it is what I felt is it does some instant staggering effects. Then, additionally, if you do a light attack.
香儿，刚刚。
Let's see through this.
反应很快，不错。
嗯。
哎，有张新的。年约二十，喜着绿衣。大王，你瞧瞧，这人像不像夫人？
没，此人画工不行，没有画出我家大小姐风姿绰约的神韵。
吉鹏大王就别生气了，李君的画工一向把人画丑。你看，画着阿兄的这张，我看了也觉得不对劲。
小鬼本来就长得不行啊。
是吗？我倒觉得不错。
I never get enough of these little teasers. Yeah, so it does some decent staggering and some damage. And the part is, when you do attacks on some of the enemies with a shield, it will bounce off their shields. But if you kick them, it will not have any. bounce animation that is coming up. So that is something that you can use for,
有没有好好对待守城的人们
shield people.
就怕将军认为老弱妇孺无意行军。
And apart from that, you know, who doesn't want to drop kick someone, you know? I like the animation, so these two stances here might be the stance that we'll stick around with for the most of the playthrough here, or the walkthrough, yep. And let's do a saving here. And we don't need to rest, we're full health. And just to quickly show off our harness souls that we have right now. Okay, so it's full. So the dexterity for parrying, but I rarely parry anyone, to be honest. So I don't know. So it's probably gonna get changed out sometime in the future. And this will have it around, and soul of healing and soul of malevolence. So these are the two base that we're running on. One gives healing effect after you defeat an enemy. So that is very good as the sustainability wise. And okay,
we're gonna
see this. And the attack, self-explanatory, we can dish out more damage and
more.
我辎重没收好，大人，再不走就来不及了。好吧，让那些贱民在前面帮我们挡着，在他们死光之前，走，兵发运水。
是。
如何？
混蛋！
啊！
快杀进去救人呐！
Just so much fun. And it got the round animation to it. So that just made our attack range that much bigger.
Ashong.这些妖魔是不是？
或许是吧。
啊？是什么？
我们从复魂牢旁引走的妖魔。当初若再坚持一点。让刘生公带村人们到御水去，或许不至于如此。
我们该劝的也都劝了，而他也早已带兵走了，谁料得到会有妖魔袭村呢？
说的是。
马，你们说的是那个面貌阴沉的小胖子吗？
大王见过。
他刚刚还在的，他还说了，让那群贱民在前面挡着，他们好逃跑。
着实无耻。
Okay. All right. I think we can wrap up this episode here, and in the next one, we'll continue to the north, return to Yushui, and continue the main story. All right. Thanks for watching. Merry Christmas again. I'll see you in the next episode.